Now, today we are going to find the electric potential. Now, electric potential is labeled by V. That is a scale. I mean, that is not a vector. It has magnitude only, but it has no direction. Now, when you are going to find the magnitude of electric potential due to the charge Q, static charge Q at distance R. Now I take this point as A. Now I am going to write the magnitude at electric potential A. A is given by 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught Q divided by R. Now this is the general expression for the electric field potential. This V generated by capital Q, it fills at distance R. Now Q should be static charge. Now when you have negative charge here, definitely you have to apply minus sign. I mean, when you write the electric potential in electric fields, you have to apply polarity in front of the charge, because this is a scale. Now when you write E, I mean that electric field intensity and force, you can't apply the polarity. But when you write the electric potential, definitely you have to write sign in front of the charge. I mean, you have to consider the polarity when you write the electric potential at a point. That's why you can take normally algebraic summation to find the resultant electric potential at a point. For example, you assume there is a static charge plus Q1, this is R1, and minus Q2, this is R2, and plus Q3, this is R3, this is Q3. Now we are going to write the resultant electric potential at A. I take this point as A. This is very important. Now, first of all, I am going to write that electric potential at for Q1. 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 divided by R. Q1 divided by R. Due to this minus Q2, Q2 divided by R2. Minus Q2 divided by R2. Finally, plus Q3 divided by R3. Now actually this is the method to write the resultant electric potential at a point. You better take 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught in front of the bracket and then write the charges with the polarities. Finally, each and every term should be divided by the distance Q1, R1, Q2, R2, and finally Q3, R3. Now this is the method to find the resultant electric potential at a point. For an example, now again we consider that previous calculation. I gave this one to find the electric field intensity in last video clip. Now again I am going to discuss about this one. Now you assume that plus 5 coulomb here, plus 2 coulomb here, minus 3 coulomb here and plus 1 coulomb here. You assume side of the square is root 2 meter. So diagonal of the square is given by 2. So one part is 1 meter. Now here I am going to find the resultant electric potential at point C. This is the method to write VC. Take 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught, write the charges with terms plus 5, plus 1, plus 2, minus 3. should be divided by the distances. What are the distances? For all charges, that is 1. Now that is okay, because that the general expression for the V is given by 1/4 pi epsilon naught Q divided by R. This is the general expression for V. V sub scale, no need to consider about the direction, it has no direction. You can take the normal simplification, normal algebraical summation to find the resultant electric potential at a point. Now, second one. Now, this is very important. Now, I am going to explain how do you find the acceleration due to the electric field. Now, by the mechanical, by the Newton's second law, you can write F equals mv. Now, you can write that F equals mv. That is the first one. Now, everyone knows, in last video clip, I explained you how do you write the E by using F. So, every time that F is given by QE. In the gravitational fields, we write F equals mg dash. Here, QE. Right. Now we can write two terms for F by using Newton's second law and by using the electric field definition. F equals ma, F equals qv. By using, you can find the acceleration here, qv divided by a. Now this is the basic theorem to find the acceleration due to the electric field. Now, another much more important thing is, there is another method to write that E. Again, E also given by negative value of gradient of voltage. Now, this is the difference of voltage. Delta V means difference of voltage. And D means distance. Now, what gradient of voltage means? Voltage difference divided by distance. Now, delta V means voltage difference. But when you do the calculation, no need to worry about this sign. I mean, don't take the sign when you do the calculation. But when you draw the variation, at that time you have to consider the minus sign. Again, I summarize it. Don't take the minus sign when you do the calculation. Definitely, you have to take this minus sign when you draw the variations. I mean the graph. So, finally, we can write three terms for E. Now, these are the three terms. When there is a static charge, electric field intensity at E are distance. E is given by 1/4 pi epsilon naught Q divided by R square. Now, this is the general expression for E by static charge Q at distance R. There's another method to write E equals F divided by Q. Now, here you can't apply polarity here and there. Finally, again we can write E equals minus value of gradient of voltage. Now, these are the three methods to write E. Now, next one, if you want to find the acceleration due to the electric field, you better write F equals F. F is given by MA. Now, here, F equals QE. So, write QE here. Take subject as A. It gives QE divided by A. Now, these are the summary. Now, here, by using this theorem, we can write the value for pendulum in electric field. Now, I draw two pendulums, simple pendulums here. Now, there is no electric field here. It has gravitational field only. You assume the distance from fixed point to the center of gravity as L. Now, in the second one, you assume there are two positive plates and negative plates. Now, you assume there is another simple pendulum here. the distance between fixed point and the center of gravity is L again. Now here I am going to write the values of periodic time for the given two simple pendulums. Now here I am going to mention the acceleration. Now it has gravitational acceleration only because it has gravitational field only. Now you can see it remains electric field here. Always electric field lies from plus to minus. Now there is another method. If it is positive charge, now you assume this is the positive charge, positive plus. Now acceleration and force parallel to the electric field direction if it is a positive charge. If it is a negative charge, you assume electric field is here. Now this is electric field. Now direction of force and acceleration opposite to the direction of electric field if it is a negative charge. I mean force and acceleration parallel to the electric field direction if it is a positive charge. If it is a negative charge, that is opposite. Now this is the theorem. Now I use this theorem for this simple pendulum. Now you can see, now electric field lies from plus to minus. Now you assume there is a charge. Now Bob is to Bob charge is Q and mass is M. Now I am going to mention the acceleration due to the two fields. This is positive charge. Electric field lies vertically downwards, so it has acceleration due to the electric field downwards. Because this is positive charge, this here. Now again, this pendulum on an earth, so it has gravitational acceleration. Always gravitational acceleration lies vertically downwards. Now you can see it has two accelerations. Now I can take the resultant acceleration as A plus G. Now I am going to write value of periodic time of simple pendulum. Now everyone knows the general expression for the simple pendulum periodic time, 2 phi root 10 over g. Next one, t equals 2 phi l over. Now we have to write the resultant acceleration due to these two fields, g plus a. Now everyone, you can write the value for a, because that f equals f, that is the theorem to find that a. Now f is given by qe and ma, qe and ma. By using this one, you can write a is given by qe divided by m. This is the value for a, as the previous one. Now you can apply this value for A. Now sometimes they ask, now they give data as V, voltage difference, and B. Now everyone knows that A value is QV divided by M. Otherwise when they give the value for data for voltage difference and distance, you can expand that E as V divided by D again. I mean, normally we can write that a means acceleration by using this theorem. A equals qe divided by m, that is the basic theorem. Now again you can expand this e, qv divided by d. Now when they give voltage difference as a data, you can apply this one again. Now here I explained you, when the Bob is positive charge, when the Bob takes negative charge, that acceleration lies upwards. At that time, resultant acceleration is given by G minus A. This should G minus A. A is given by this one. Otherwise, when they give V as a data, it is given by this one. Now that is the method to find the
periodic time in electric field. Sometimes they ask about the projectile motion in the electric field. At that time, again you have to take A as this one due to the electric field. Now this is the basic theorem to find the potential and the acceleration in electric field. Now these are the basic theorem about the electric potential. Now we will discuss about the potential again in next clip.